happen that way. So I sat down. Just in a moment, here come that, I call it super anointing, swept over again, and I was almost off of my feet and say, say what you will and it shall be given you. I looked through the woods until I found another tree some 50 yards away. Had a lot of brush in it and grapevines and things wrapped around where squirrels seldom ever take a tree like that. I said, and there shall be another young fox squirrel sitting right there. And I took my finger down and looked around through the woods and looked back, and there sat the fox squirrel looking right at me again.
Amen.
I shot that one, picked him up. I thought, oh, I was trembling. I felt, thank the great mighty God of heaven is here in the woods. And he's confirming to me in my own way hunting here that he's going to do just exactly what he told me 15 years ago.
Amen.
I watched it a little bit. I said, Lord, it shall happen again. He said, speak the place where it'll be. I said, I'll make this radical. I said, that old snag sticking out there by the side of the field, bare, slick, and white. I said, there shall come another red squirrel, and he'll go out on the end of that snag and look out over the field at the farmers. That'll be that way. I looked back and there was no squirrel there. I looked for about 5 minutes, there was still no squirrel. I said, two squirrels is fine. I said, two's a witness. I'll believe it like that. And something said, but you said there would be one. I waited another 5 minutes, nothing. And it kept quoting in my heart, you said there'd be one. I waited and waited. Something said, are you doubting? I said, not one bit. And I no more said that till out that limb went the red squirrel, stood and looked at the farmers. God's my judge standing here.
Amen.
I shot the squirrel. Went over and picked him up and walked through the woods till I was way hours past picking the boys up to see if there'd even be one more anywhere, and there wasn't.
Amen.
Then I come home and told you about it. And then on November the 6th, and that anointing comes so great that I could hardly stand on the ground. It said, speak what you say, don't doubt, and you can have what you've said. I said, I shall get three squirrels. He said, where will they come from? I said, one will come from that way, one from that way, and one back this way. Make it radical. God don't care how radical it seems. He's God of circumstance. And while I stood there for about a few minutes, I could hear no shooting of the rest of the boys around anywhere. I happened to look to my back. Way up in the woods, about 90 yards, I thought something was on a stump. I watched it. After all, it jumped off, and it was a gray squirrel. So far, all the way across the hollered up on top of the ridge. When it come along by the side of the tree, I shot it at about 90 yards, and it killed it. I said, there's one. I might as well turn and look this other way for the others, because they're coming. See, God has a way of bringing things to you.
Amen.
Making you sure what you're talking about. That anointing is off of me then. Well, I waited and watched this way for about an hour. Nothing happened. I was getting cold. And I thought, surely, if that is the Holy Spirit that's telling me those things, it will be just exactly because when the anointing was on me, I spoke that word. And it'll have to be that way. Now listen real close to this. And this is going to be a tape recording. It'll go all over the world. Now, and then to my left, I kept watching. After a while, I looked up on a tree coming around a beech tree. There come a gray squirrel. I said, just exactly that way. That's right, Lord. I turned down, raised up to shoot him, and there come another squirrel. I said, there's two. Just exactly. Make my three. I raised down, shot the first squirrel. The other one run under a log. I could see him cutting on a hickory nut or something under the log. A log is about that high at the end. Larry's up about a foot. I could see the squirrel. I killed the first one. I said, now I'll get the other one. I had to interpret what he just said. I couldn't hear him this right. and that super anointing swept over me. Said, tell Hattie that she's found grace in the sight of God. Who would have thought? Said, tell her to ask whatever she will. Then you speak it by this gift into existence.
Amen.
Whatever she asked, speak it into existence. I looked at Sister Hattie. The first time it was ever performed on a human being. I said, Sister Hattie, ask what you will. God's going to give it to you. What do you think of that? Does it get into you? 7 times he had confirmed it by an animal. 7 is God's complete number. Here's the first time on a human being. And he, what did he choose? Some great aristocrat? A great noted minister? A poor little widow woman that can hardly write her name? God knows what he's doing. Said, ask what you will. Hattie said to me, Brother Branham, what do you mean? I said, ask anything your heart desires, and it shall be produced right here, that you'll know that the Lord God of heaven answers, and his scriptures are true. My first time with the new gift, my first anointing, I could hardly hear. And she looked around. We've been talking about her little crippled sister. I said, oh, no doubt in my heart, within a few minutes, little Edith will be jumping to the glory of God. Hattie looked around, all around, and she said, Brother Bill, my greatest desire is for the salvation of my 2 boys. Why there couldn't have been a greater thing. She could have asked for $10,000, she'd have got it. What if it had been some millionaire would have asked for another million? God knows what she's going to ask for. Sister Hattie, at least 7 or 8 witnesses standing there. All you people that was present when that happened, raise up your hand. Everybody in the building was present that happened. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 7 of them. 8 of them. 8 of them was present when that happened. I said, ask anything you want to, because God's give it to me to give to you whatever you want. She said her boys was beginning to go off on the teenage tantrum. And she said, the salvation of my 2 boys. I said, by the will of God, by the power of God, I give you in the name of Jesus Christ your desire. And her 2 boys shook under the power of God. And that old building trembled. Banks fell into his plate, shall be grabbed. And Hattie screamed to you could hear her for 2 blocks. And them 2 boys with tears rolling down their cheeks received exactly what they asked for right there. Oh, the first time it was ever used on a human being. Ask what you will, and it shall be given unto you. Her boy sitting there with her this morning. What would she have asked? What if she'd asked the healing of her little sister? What if she'd asked that? The little girl would have been healed, but her 2 boys lost. What if that poor widow who had just told me that she tried to give to this church $50 on a pledge to help build a new church, and Brother Roberson wouldn't take it and only let her give 20 of it. And I said to myself, when she's speaking, I'll give her back the 20, but God.